afternoon. First of all, I'd like to express my gratitude, Academic Science President, to provide me the opportunity to share my knowledge of my work on paleoclimate Northeast India region. I am also very grateful to Ramesh recommend my name for this talk. Today I am going to speak changes of vegetation vis-à-vis climate change since last 7,000 years for Northeast India. I have taken pollen as a proxy. You know, through analyzing pollen, we could understand the vegetation. We can build the vegetation, and since the vegetation is linked with the climate, so we can reconstruct climate through pollen studies. And Northeast India region is a unique region as a phytogeographical point of view. It is the hotspot of the migration of taxa from the different geographical regions, mainly from China, Malaysia, and according to Professor Tataja, even Northeast India is the center for origin of higher plants. And according to Webinar, this is the zone where the migration of the taxa from different geographical regions took place. Even in the one view is that this is the region from where from the this link between the vegetation of South India Virgin Hills and these. So to understand the phytogeographical changes for long time range and interlinked to the climate, we need long record. Our historical records are very short, so we have to extend this record through using proxy data. So there are several proxy data used in the geological, biological, chemical science, and I am mainly working the biological proxy. And the biological proxies, I have taken interest in tilling and pollen. And in this talk, I would like to talk on how tilling and pollen could be useful studying paleoclimate of Northeast region. So, because every proxy data, I mean that their formation is linked to the climate and that can be dated. So every proxy data is responds to different aspects of climate change. Some respond to temperature, precipitation, disturbance, and every proxy data has its time range. Some are very short period, some are long period. So tilling data is useful to study the short-term climatic changes. We have started tilling from the Himalayan region. This is the tilling study we made from the western Himalayan region, Gangotri region. And we found that several trees, especially growing in the higher elevation, are very suitable for the climatic studies as well as other phenomena which are linked to the climate. We got these tilling samples through the implement border, and these are several conifers, large, this is large tree which are close to the glaciers, then virus Walachina, there's also close to the glaciers. These trees are found suitable for tilling analysis. So, based on the tilling analysis, we reconstruct mass clearance of the Northwest Himalayan regions, and we concluded that mass clearance is which is linked with the glacial movement, and during little ice age, that is 1580 to 1850 AD, is not much severe as in elsewhere in Northern Hemisphere. We, based on tilling data, we have taken the mass balance data, and also made link with the other climatic parameters. So, in addition to that, in the Sikkim Himalaya, based on tilling data, we extend the existing still flow record long back, and we have recorded several periods of high discharge and low discharge of times years. So, but today in this talk, I will give emphasis only pollen grains, because pollen grains we can go. Further longer period than tilling. So, just to refresh our knowledge, first I will tell what is pollen grains. Although we all know what pollen grains, how the pollen grains are linked with the climate change, and how we build the vegetation from the pollen grains, so far. What paleoclimatic inference and vegetation changes we made from northeast India. Retrieve the pollen grains from the sediments, pollen grains coming from the local plants as well as from long distance, the local plant and extra-local pollen grains. So just we are counting pollen grains and making diagrams, and it is not to make the vegetation, so we have to find out how much pollen grains is coming from the local area, how much pollen grains is coming from the long distance transport. So we study pollen profile, take from the resistant deposit, and we build the chronology by isotope grading, mostly radiocarbon grading. And by vegetation infra pollen proxy, which could be analyzed to past climate and can be linked with the desert fluctuation, tilt and shift, others. And this data can also could be correlated with other proxy studies from the same profile. So, in the northwest India, we know it consists of seven states, popularly known as seven sisters. And one brother is Sikkim. So we have covered all the entire states of the northeast India, but we detailed work we did from the Arunachal Pradesh. So in the Manipur, also we found the very suitable for pollen study. We collected samples from the Lota clay, and this work is carried out in the Ocean Institute. And this is the sediment profile, and this from the sediment profile we did what the pollen grains, and these are the pollen grains percentage and the carbon base, and the changes of the vegetation we infer the climate changes. So we recorded the climatic changes during the last 4,000 years from the Lota Lake Manipur regions. And Nagaland also one of the suitable sites for the pollen analysis. But so far we collected samples on the Joko Valley, and one of my students, the first project, she's working in this project to study the vegetation forest, also the anti-human interference in the vegetation history, because this area is very common for fires there. So, in addition to the sediments close to the lakes, we also try to collect sediments from the inside of the lake. So the sediment borer, we did give a, because samples will be unstable, I give a very high distribution scenario. And we studied also pollen study from the Tripura. The studies covered from 7,000 years before present to modern days. We found that this area is continuing deciduous forest with some changes of the dry elements. So you get the phases of some dry climate within the moist deciduous environment. And Meghalaya, one of the unique sites for the pollen studies, because it's a diversified vegetation and the area having extreme range of precipitation. So we have started work in the Meghalaya region also, but it's very difficult to get the suitable sample from this year, because here the due to tectonic disturbance and due to too much soil erosion and due to huge human disturbance, that is very difficult to get the samples. From the ground, we have collected samples, and we try to find out that what are the representation of the garu vegetation in terms of pollen grains. And these are the pollen grains recovered from the sediments from garu here. There are samples collected from the Bolapur Karu Valley. And these are the vegetation of this area. Even these, all of this insectivorous plant. And we recovered the different types of pollen grains. And we try to find out the samples collected different forest types, how the different forest types is represented in the through pollen grain, so that is database we could use in the interpreting the past vegetation. So this study identified that Dubhunja Sina upon this pollen place in this Balapakaru Valley, it needs high amount of water. So if you get this pollen, so it will indicate the moist climate. And some of the areas where we are getting the pollen grains of artificial grasses, bulbs, this will indicate the area was covered by some forest under dry climate. And this database could be used in our future studies to interpret longer time scale lake profile. So, in addition to this, in Khasi, we made a reconnaissance survey for quartered sediments. There was one professor, geographic department of this university, professor at Blue Simply, and we found that several sites in the like non-crag, this was in Cherrapunji, this area will be suitable for the pollen studies. We have started pollen study for this area, and we have dated the samples, and this will cover last 10,000 history, that is 10,000 years. That's called Holocene period. And Assam, which is one of the most biodiversified region of this area, there are several work that we've done also, scientists of people should institute to study the vegetal history, and this goes also record goes to 10,000 years before. This is the case studies from the vegetation history from the Lord of Fratin Valley from Naugao, and we made the vegetation changes. This is the dates, along the dates, this is the pollen dates, we must the vegetation, and we reported the several phases of changes of vegetation and linked to the climatic changes. And Arunachal Pradesh is one of the classical sites for the study of paleoclimate. And we collected sediments as well as already analyzed on several sites from Lord Altitude, Bhanga Lake, Jiru Valley, then from high altitude Paradise Lakes, Pitisho Lake, and Pamsuba. This is also, this site is unique because this site gives us scenery of the vegetation history plus and climate covering last several thousand years. Our data goes back to 60,000 years before present. And one of the most classical site for pollen study is the Geovalley. It is in Lower Swansea district. This is a huge lake deposit and is comparable to the deposit of Kashmir Karawar deposits. And is unique for the paleontology studies. And we reported peat from this region, and these peats are very good for study of the paleoclimate regions. And we have dated this peat, and this peat goes beyond the 40,000 years before present. And we extrapolated the date, our date goes to 66,000 years before present. And we studied totally the pollen study from this area. And this paper published in USR. And we found a record that since 60,000 years, optimum climate and vegetation was during 34,000 to 36,000 years. And around 20,000 BP, that area was a maximum cold, that is equivalent to LGM, last glacial maximum, while monsoon was low and vegetation was dry savanna. Actually, this pollen diagram has been interpreted between the interplay of the pine forest versus oak forest and grass. When the climate becomes dry, then oak forest decline and invaded by pine and grasses. So we have reported several species of invasion of pine grasses within the oak forest. Actually, this area will be suitable for the broadleaf forest, but due to the climatic changes, these things. So we reported within the last glacial maximum, that 20,000 years before, the area is covered by grassland, and 34,000 to 36,000 years, this is the maximum evolutionary climate during the last glaciation. We call it interstradial, and these interstradial phases also you recognize many parts of the Kashmir regions. And from the Sogar Lake also, we have studied pollen. Sogar Lake is in Ladakh, from 4,000 meters altitudes. There we also studied pollen. We also recorded that during the same time, 30,000 years to 34,000 years, climate was optimum during the last glacial trend, and when the area also covered by juniper forest. And another area study of one of the Paris Lake is 4,000 meters, and this gives the picture of the short time span. So these pollen diagrams cover the date only 1280 to water, and we have recorded the changes of vegetation or the tilt shifting at this region, and based on this fluctuation of the tree elements, we inferred that around 1800 BP, around 1280, that conifer broadleaf forest grew in the vicinity of the site under one marsh climate similar to present day. And we started probably more onward during 11,000 BP, equivalent to around 1985 AD. This is corresponding to medieval one period. And glacier seems to recede, and tree line might have been closer to site around 50 years BC, around 1480. This is equivalent to little ices. So during little ices, tree line descended down. So as a whole, the salient feature our study for the Northeast India, it is that any experience
speed one we will face about 36 to 34,000 years BP. Climate was become cold, dry, around 20,000 years to 80,000 years, possibly due to LGM period.
What is that sign? Sign, changed sign, last S-I-N-E, what is that?
What?
In the topic, since changes it sign since last it is since several thousand years of northeast since changes
since
and
since So dry climate is reported about 14,000 years in Assam, and analysis dated back to an particular area around 17,000 years. We have reported Northeast Asian elements like Kenya, Pandora, Suga, which are not going today. So this also indicates the trends migrated in between India and countries of Northeast. We recorded 3 years of younger dryas in the pollen records from Lower Assam regions. Younger dryas is 11,000 years BP. There was another phase of colder climate. We have recorded the beginning of rice cultivation in Tripura region around 5,700 years BP. Climate of the whole of Northeast Asia India experienced warm moist climate between 5,000 to recent time, with the limited, but it is interpreted with some short period of cooler and warmer phases, cooler phases utilizes, and warmer phase pretty warm period utilizes around 1500 to 1800 AD, and many more we have never also anthropogenic effect in the pollen diagram. But as the overview of these studies, we reported that the nothing region is not data was not sufficient to understand the climate changes covering major types of the quadrant here. The nuclear data so far we brought out in terms of only temperature, and precipitation, and water perspective, pulmon, or light.